Ninh explains the rules of Calcio Storico. The object of the game is to score more goals, or caccia, than the other team. Calcio Storico, otherwise known as Calcio Fiorentino, is an Italian sport that's played between two teams of 27 and played on a rectangular sand and dirt field that measures 80 metres long and 40 metres wide. There are nets at each end of the field and span the whole width of the playing area. To score, all you have to do is push or kick the ball into the other team's net. If you successfully push or kick the ball into the net, this is a caccia and this scores one goal. And to get the ball into the net, you can move the ball by almost any means necessary. That's right, if you haven't already noticed, you're allowed to punch your opponent, kick your opponent, tackle, wrestle, and you can even headbutt and choke them if you want to. It's perfectly legal, and pretty much anything goes. Think football, mixed with rugby, mixed with mixed martial arts, and Millwall fans, and you get this game. As mentioned before, there are 27 players on each team. They consist of 4 goalkeepers, 3 fullbacks, 5 halfbacks, and 15 forwards. The strategy of the game is for the forwards of the team to injure, incapacitate, or tire out the opposing team, while the backs run with the ball and try and score. There are no substitutes in this game. Once you're done, you're pretty much done. Whoa, Ninh, that's mad! Yep. Calcio Storico is Italy's version of medieval or mob football, and was their original version of football before soccer was invented. Once a caccia has been scored, both teams change ends. The game is played in just one period of 50 minutes. The team with the high score at the end of time wins. That's basically all you'll need to know about Calcio Storico, but there's a few other things that you'll need to know before playing or watching this game. For example, half caccia. One of the few rules in the game is that the ball cannot go over the net. If you shoot the ball and it goes over, the other team is awarded half a caccia or half a goal. The players. There are no professional players of Calcio Storico. If you want to play, you have to be a volunteer. I should also mention that players play the game knowing full well that they will probably leave the game injured, and sometimes worse. Things you cannot do. There's only a few things you cannot do in Calcio Storico, namely kicks to the head, especially if they're on the floor, and it's also illegal for more than one player to attack an opponent. Doing these things will automatically get you ejected from the game. If you like this video, please comment, rate and subscribe. It takes me ages to make one of these things, and good karma is very much appreciated. Be sure to follow me on Twitter and Reddit also, but in the meantime, enjoy Calcio Storico. If you're brave enough to play it, that is.